smart shopping carts have been around for a while now. You know, you may have seen some that has small LED screens on the cart as you walk through the store. It can help you find, you know, fruits and vegetables or whatever you're looking for. That's not what we're talking about with these new smart carts. For example, Kroger is testing about 20 smart carts at a supermarket in Cincinnati. And these things are driven by artificial intelligence, believe it or not. They also have wireless connectivity. What happens is you walk down the aisle with your cart, you reach up and you grab a can of beans, and you take the beans and you put it into your cart. Well, as you're doing that, there's three different cameras that are looking at that can from different directions. And the artificial intelligence says, okay, that's a can of beans and it costs 79 cents. So you drop it into your cart, look at your monitor. Now you owe Kroger 79 cents plus tax. So that's the basics of it, but they actually have a video screen on them, a card swipe terminal. So you can actually fill up your cart, you roll right out the door, you swipe it and you keep on going. And this is really good for pandemic reasons, because that's how they're marketing it. It's a no touch, low touch for pandemics. You don't have to hand stuff off to a checker. Checker's not handling all your stuff, put it in bags. This way it just goes right out the door. You're the only person theoretically that's touched it to this point. But then it also works in reverse. Let's say you're shopping and you have that can of beans and you decide, I don't want that can of beans anymore. You reach into your cart to grab it, same idea. The cameras work with the artificial intelligence to take a look at that can and say, uh-oh, it's going out of the cart now. So let's deduct 79 cents off the total, which you'll see right on your touchscreen right in front of you, which is kind of cool in that regard. Other companies such as Amazon, Whole Foods are testing other solutions like this. I think the one they're using at Kroger looks like has a very good chance of becoming more mainstream. And here's why. You basically don't have to talk to any humans. And more what I found is people don't like talking to humans anymore. So by using a grocery cart that's smart, you only have to interact with the grocery cart itself. Now, with that said, once we get these out there rolling around, they're going to have Wi-Fi. And one of the things that's going to enable that is the 5G technology that's coming down the pipe. But they're going to have Wi-Fi on there. So why wouldn't they be able to connect to your smartphone or to your smartwatch and these sort of things? And just basically do like what the Amazon store, some of them do, just walk right out the door and your smartphone pays for it as you leave. So interesting technology. They're testing it in many places. These things are on the way. There's no doubt about it. Whether you're going to see your entire store full of them, I doubt it. But it's going to be an option for some people. Just like nowadays, we have, you can use a basket, you can use a small cart, you can use a large cart, or you can drive the one around that's electric. This will just be one more option. You can drive this one around it that's smart, that's keeping track of you. And what's the payoff? These carts cost like a couple grand, right? So what's the payoff? Well, the payoff is the grocery store gets really, really good marketing information about you. They probably don't have it. I haven't seen the data, so don't quote me. They probably don't have it linked to your individual person, but they know that you are a 35-year-old female, perhaps. And then what they're trying to do is collect that data on what do 35-year-old females like to buy at the store. Or if somebody buys a 79-cent can of beans, what can we flash on this smart screen and say, hey, you bought the beans, now go down here and buy the cornbread, you know, these sort of things. So you're basically going to be pushing a little salesman around in your cart as you go. The idea of it is it's going to be smarter, faster, and easier. In the long term, it's probably going to be a lot faster, easier for the grocer rather than us.